Okay, so let us start the session. Yesterday, in our introduction session, I have already discussed about the introduction part of our module. Okay, can you hear me?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
And you can yes, see the screen, right? You can see the screen, right?
Yes, sir. Yes,
sir. Okay. Then, last class, we had discussed about introduction part of our module and also a derivation, which is, I said, is important in our module, that is law of conservation of mass, based on law of conservation of mass, that is continuity equation, rho 1 a 1 c 1 equal to rho 2 a 2 c 2. So please go through the video I have uploaded and note once again the derivation and be familiar with it. And also study the other two derivation which I will give you as an assignment, that is conservation of momentum and conservation of energy. The three derivations are very important. Any one of the three will be asking to your university question paper. Okay. So for today's session, I am going to explain about an important term, which will be very important for doing your problem in all the five modules. That is the very key term that we are using in this particular four chapter for taking values in your data, that is Mach number. Mach number. MACHNUMBER. Mach number. It is a non-dimensional term. It is denoted by capital letter M. Okay. Mach number. So you want to be very familiarized with this particular Mach number M, because in every module, you are dealing with data book by considering the value of the Mach number. Okay. Mach number, the Mach number value will be given in your problem, particular gas of Mach number 1.6 or Mach number 2.2, and something properties will be given. And you will be going through the data book by the value Mach number at a particular flow. If it is Fanon flow, if it is Rayleigh flow, if it is isentropic flow, etc., etc. So Mach number is a key term to do the problems. So what is Mach number? Mach number is a non-dimensional term. Okay, very important one. It's a non-dimensional. It is only a number. This doesn't possess any unit. Non-dimensional number. And it is expressed by the notation capital M, and is defined as the ratio of fluid velocity divided by air velocity. M equal to C by S. Simply, it can be denoted by the ratio of fluid velocity to air velocity, sound velocity. As I said yesterday, we can express fluid velocity as C and sound velocity as A. Mach number M is the ratio of velocity of sound. It can be also expressed how the particular derivation M equal to C by A, how we came. The definition for the Mach number can be expressed as inertia force divided by elastic force. Inertia force divided by elastic force. So inertia force have an equation that rho a c square. Is a general equation for inertia force, and also elastic force can be expressed as K into A, where K is the modulus of velocity, A is the area, and we can say rho A C square, that A and A will get cancelled, and the remaining term will be rho C square by K. Rho C square by K. Rho C square by K equal to the particular number. And also we know that that is the main explanation for Mach number, that is inertia force by elastic force, and that particular derivation is revising into many many steps and arriving at a condition where M equal to C by A, M equal to C by A, or M square equal to C square by A square, therefore M equal to C by A. Then what is A? A is sound velocity. As I said, A is the velocity of sound. So A have a equation. A can be expressed in every session every problem you are taking this value for a. That is a, you have to buy a constant equation, that is a equal to root gamma rt. It's a very important equation. You must take note down the value, note down the equation, and you want to place it in a box and mark it as important. Mach number m equal to c by a, and a equal to root gamma rt, where gamma is the ratio of cp by cv. Gamma is the ratio of cp to cv, specific constant pressure to specific and constant volume. R is the characteristic gas constant. For air, we are taking 0.287, right? And T is the temperature. So in every problem, we are taking the value for A, we are calculating the value for A and M. If M is not given, either A is will be given and C is given, you can take the value of M by that basic equation. So M equal to C by A, or M equal to C by root gamma RT. Root gamma RT, Mach number M. It is a non-dimensional term which can be defined as the ratio of inertia force to elastic force, or after several terms, we can also define it as a simple term. It is a ratio of what is Mach number? Originally, you want to say that Mach number is a ratio of fluid velocity to velocity of sound, C by A, M equal to C by A. Okay, that is the one of the important term you want to study in this module. And coming to your next topic, we have already studied about the equation for steady state energy, steady state SFE equation. I think you have studied in thermodynamics, second law of thermodynamics, first law of thermodynamics, first law applied for a non-flow process or flow process. SFE, steady flow energy equation. The equation was H1 plus C1 square by 2 plus Z1 into G plus Q equal to H2 plus C2 square by 2 Z2 into G plus W. This was the equation for SFEE, steady flow energy equation. How does we have derived that equation? So in that condition, for the, I am revising the chapter again for thermodynamics. You want to thorough with that. That is why I am saying that. So we have a particular system, and we are taking entry condition and exit condition for the system. This is entry condition, this is exit condition. So for entry condition, we are taking over the notation as one, P1, B1, H1, okay, enthalpy 1, etc, 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 C1, etc, flow from over to inside. And outside, we are taking all the two conditions, P2, B2, H2, C2. Okay, then there will be a base for the system, and the initial state force, the datum head, Z1, and the final stage we are taking it as Z2. This is our figure. This was our figure for studying thermodynamics, for deriving the steady flow energy equation. Steady flow energy equation. So I am deriving once more it. P1, V1, H1, C1 are over here in the left side, that is entry condition, and P2, V2, H2, C2 are in exit condition, that is in seconds. So Z1 and Z2 are the datum head from the base. Initially, for entry condition, it is taken as Z1, and final condition, it is taken as Z2. Right? So our generalized equation for first law, or generalized equation for the first law, we have studied that Q equal to W plus U2 U minus U1, or E2 minus E1. If it is energy, if it is internal energy, we are taking Q equal to U2 minus U1 plus W, or E2 minus E1 plus W. This was our general equation for first. You want to say that Q equal to U2 minus U1 plus W, or Q equal to E2 minus U1 plus W. That is, Q is the rate of heat transfer, that is, heat transfer is represented by Q, W is work transfer, E2 minus E1 is the change in energy, or U2 minus E1 is the change in internal energy. This was a generalized equation for first law. So what is E here? Energy, right? Energy and E. So what are the energy posing here? What are different types of energy we have studied here? First one is internal energy U. Internal energy U plus potential energy plus kinetic energy. There are three main energy happening here. That is, first one is internal energy, that is energy inside, for energy developing inside the particular system, it is internal energy. And always we have a potential energy. Potential energy can be written by MGZ. MGH was our normal equation, that is height. Here it is Z. So MGZ plus what is the mc square, half mc square is a kinetic energy. E equal to u plus mg slightly plus half mc square is a total energy happening here. Total energy. Okay. So taking differentiate of the equation, by taking differential, we will get dE equal to du plus mg, and is a constant, m is a mass, g is gravity, is a constant, mg dz, d is changing here, d, z1 and z2, so dz plus half m is a constant value, m is a constant, taking outside m into d of half mc square. So here we are taking differential, dE is energy is changing, dE equal to du, internal energy will be changing, plus mg z kodukumbol, m is a constant, g is a constant, m is a mass and g is gravitational at endpoint 81, so z is changing here, z1 to z2, so mg dz plus m is a constant here, m is taking outside, m of d of half mc square, differential code. Then what is the change in internal energy, d e2 minus e1, change in energy, you want to find the value here, I'm substituting e2 minus e1, okay. e2 minus e1 എടുക്കുമ്പോൾ ഇനീഷ്യൽ പൊസിഷൻ ഫൈനൽ പൊസിഷൻ യു വിൽ ഗെറ്റ് ദ വാല്യൂ ആസ് 1 to 2 ഫ്രം ഫസ്റ്റ് സ്റ്റേജ് ടു സെക്കൻഡ് സ്റ്റേജ് ഹിയർ ഈസ് സെക്കൻഡ് ഫസ്റ്റ് സ്റ്റേജ് ആൻഡ് ഹിയർ ഈസ് സെക്കൻഡ് സ്റ്റേജ് ഫ്രം 1 to 2 ദ ഹോൾ ഇക്വേഷൻ വിൽ ബി ചേഞ്ചിങ് ലൈക് ദാറ്റ് DE integral 1 to 2 DE plus integral 1 to 2 DU plus MG integral 1 to 2 DZ. That is, Z is also changing from Z1 to Z2, right? U is also changing by here U1, U2. U1 is also changing from 1 to 2 plus last one. Half can be also taken outside, right? Half M into 1 to 2 dc square. So directly you can arrive at a value that in what is integral 1 to 2 de, integral de is e, integral du is u, integral dz is z, integral dc square is c square, you can take c square. So integral de is d, so 1 to 2 means e2 minus e1, we are applying limit 1 to 2, integral e2 is at is like that, e of 1 to 2 will be the answer for integral DE. So when we take in the upper limit, lower limit, we can get E2 minus E1 here. So like that, in every equation, you will get the whole equation will change into E2 minus E1 plus, okay, E2 minus E1, that is DE, DE equal to that particular equation U, U2 minus U1 plus MG Z2 minus Z1 plus half M into C2 square minus C1 square. Half mu into C2 square minus C1 square. So substitute the value for E2 minus C1 here in our first equation. Q equal to W plus E2 minus C1. Substitute the value, the E2 minus E1, we will get the whole equation as E2 minus E1 equal to that value. Therefore, Q equal to, our equation is Q equal W plus E2 minus E1. Q equal to W plus U2 minus U1 plus MG Z2 minus Z1 plus half M into C2 square minus C1 square. So that is the normal general equation for a energy condition. It is not a flow process. It is not a non-flow process. So it is a general equation for a system under process. Another energy of a suitable or a general equation for a process, that is work done plus U2 minus U1 change in internal energy plus MG Z2 minus Z1 means potential energy plus half m into c q square minus c1 square is kinetic energy from initial condition to final condition, entry condition to exit condition. That is the equation for a general condition. Okay, general condition. So from this equation, you can take the equation for non-flow process, for flow process, etc. For flow process and for non-flow process, etc. We can take the same equation. The change will be there. Some sort of change will be there. Okay. So the final, that is the main equation, SFEE equation, was our steady flow energy equation. That is for flow process. Flow process. Steady flow energy equation. That is for flow process. So for non-flow process, the equation will be very small. Non-flow process means there is no kinetic energy, there is no potential energy will be happening here. So the flow process, the equation will be very small equation. For steady flow energy equation will be a lengthy equation that we have studied in the thermodynamics, first law of thermodynamics. It was that was the equation I have derived in the first one, that is H1 plus. This equation will be changing like that. H1 plus C1 square by 2 plus. H2 plus P2 square by 2 plus Z2 into G plus W. Left side is Q and right side is W. That is the steady flow energy equation that we have already studied in our thermodynamics. First law of thermodynamics, steady flow energy equation. Okay. Steady flow energy equation. So, in the way, when we are taking a flow equation, there is a W value here. We can apply a value for W as PV. Work done is a PV, pressure into velocity, PV. So P1 E2 minus P1 E1 now. So P2 plus U2, P1 V1 plus U1, this H1, P2 V2 plus U2 will be H2. And that is the step that is coming. And after, H1 will be in the left side and H2 will be in the right side. Initial conditions are always in left side. Final conditions are always in left side. H1 plus C1 square by 2 plus H1 into G plus Q equal to H2 plus C2 square by 2 plus Z2 into G. So we can convert this equation very simply for an adiabatic process. We can convert this generalized steady flow equation for an adiabatic process very simply. How can we take? For adiabatic process, Qy will be 0. Qy will be 0 for adiabatic process. Also, W value will be also taken as 0. Okay, then there will be no kinetic energy and no potential energy. We are assuming that by comparing with the other products, the whole kinetic energy potential energy will be very small. So we are avoiding the whole kinetic energy value, potential energy value to zero. Adiabatic process. Sorry, only potential energy will be zero. Only the potential energy value will be zero here. Kinetic energy will be there. So we can convert this equation very simply to a adiabatic process, that is H1 plus half C1 square or C1 square by 2 equal to H2 plus half C2 square. It is the equation for an adiabatic process. So it is a generalized equation. So and this for this equation, the value heat transfer will be zero. Work transfer will be zero because it is an adiabatic process. So in a definition for adiabatic process is, for adiabatic process, there is no heat transfer taking place here. There is no heat transfer happening here. Therefore, we can say that for an adiabatic process, Q equal to zero. Therefore, W is also equal to zero. Potential energy is also zero because it is a flow process. There is no non-flow process only. Potential energy zero. It is a flow process. If it is in non-flow process, if it is in rust, we can say this have a no kinetic energy and only potential energy. If it is a flowing process, they can say potential energy equal to zero, but kinetic energy will be there, right? Moving in the kinetic energy down, rusting potential energy down. That is our condition. We are in general condition. Okay, that we are applying here. Therefore, Z down into G, that particular height can also taken as zero. There is no any other mg set. There is no potential energy. There is no work done. There is no heat transfer. So we can directly convert this equation into H1 plus half C1 square equal to H2 plus half C2 square. It is the general equation for an adiabatic process. It is very important. General equation for an adiabatic process. H1 plus half C1 square equal to H2 plus half C2 square. Okay. Note the point. H1 plus half C1 square equal to H2 plus half C2 square. It is a general energy equation for adiabatic process. Okay. It is an energy equation for adiabatic process. It is not an adiabatic process equation. How we can say what is the general form of an adiabatic equation? Aring arayo. A general form of an adiabatic equation. PV raised to gamma equal to constant. Gamma equal to constant. This is for adiabatic process. Okay. Adiabatic process. We can say what is the notation for adiabatic process? We can say PV raised to gamma equal to constant. It is equation for adiabatic process. And polytrophic process, we can say PV raised to same equation, PV raised to n equal to constant, it is polytrophic process. And isothermal process, we can say it has PV equal to constant. These are the three condition equation for three process. For adiabatic process, that is general equation for an adiabatic process is PV raised to gamma equal to constant. General form of an adiabatic process. So this equation is a general energy equation for an adiabatic process. Energy equation for an adiabatic process. And we have derived this equation from steady flow energy equation. That is this equation. And from this equation, we can say potential energy equal to zero. Then potential energy on set down into G. That is set down into G. How we can say it is a potential energy? So this is all in specific value. That is mass equal to one. We are taking here mass equal to one. That is a total equation. If mass in the kilo, that is C1 square is equal. We are taking potential energy, sorry, kinetic energy as C1 square by 2. We know that the normal equation for an adiabatic kinetic energy is half mv square or half mc square. You are not using notation for v for velocity. Here we are only using c, right? For the whole module, we are taking the notation c for velocity. So node v is the, so half mc square will be our kinetic energy and mg side will be our potential energy. So here we are taking that mass equal to unity for all in specific value. If we take on mass as consideration, the value will be capital H1 plus mc1 square by 2 plus mz into g plus like that. So it is a specific values, that is mass is taken as 1 here. So Z1 into G is the potential energy, C1 square by 2 is the kinetic energy. So we have converted the value into adiabatic energy equation, that is H1 plus equal to H2 plus half C2 square. Okay, that is all about energy equations. So we have completed a major portion of our module of energy equations. Normal a general equation for energy process is here Q equal to W plus U2 minus U1, that is Q equal to W plus total energy. And second, we have taken steady flow energy equation, that we have already studied in thermodynamics, and we have derived adiabatic energy equation from that is Q equal to 1 and Q equal to W equal to 0 and mg is also equal to 0. We have got adiabatic energy equation. So that is all about energy. So we have studied what is Mach number and what is the equation for adiabatic process. Okay. Reversible adiabatic, no, reversible adiabatic. Isentropic process. That is the second module whole topic about isentropic process. So if you heard about isentropic and you have again heard about reversible adiabatic, you just want to imagine that the both are same. Reversible adiabatic means simply isentropic itself. Isentropic process means entropy is constant. Entropy is constant. Isentropic process. So in that, if you have brought button or you have a PDF for a data book for CFF, you can see that for table for isentropic flow. Okay, second module problem. Table for isentropic flow. Table for fan of flow. Table for Rayleigh flow, etc., etc., etc. Okay. So second, I'm moving to another topic, very important topic in our module, Mach number and stagnation state are the very important thing we have to study for acquire information about that whole modules. That is stagnation states and Mach number. Very important topics: stagnation states and Mach number. So Mach number, we have already discussed about Mach number. Mach number equals E by A. So what is stagnation state? Stagnation state. So stagnation state is a very important term. Stagnation state, you have to study about stagnation temperature, stagnation velocity, stagnation pressure, stagnation enthalpy, stagnation density, etc., etc., etc. So before studying the whole thing, you want to study what is stagnation state, what is simply called as stagnation property or stagnation state. So any process when it is decelerating to zero velocity, decelerating to zero velocity, that is it is going to stop, and that particular when the c1 equal to zero, velocity become to zero, adhu process vannu zero like kutti nikkum, when the whole process is tending to zero velocity, at that position we can say it is a stagnation state. A stagnation state is defined as the state where velocity equal to zero, fluid velocity c equal to zero, we can say it is a stagnation state. Okay, the main explanation for stagnation, which I will be providing in lecture note, that is stagnation state, that is state of fluid obtained by a process when it is isentropically decelerating to zero velocity. Isentropically, which means entropy constant, isentropically decelerating to zero velocity at a zero elevation. The main point, zero elevation. So when c equal tends to zero, we can say it is a stagnation state. Okay, it is represented by a not, that means zero. If we are taking a stagnation temperature, it is known as T naught, not T zero, T naught. If we are taking stagnation pressure, it is P naught. We are taking stagnation velocity of sound, we are taking A naught. Stagnation enthalpy, H naught. Stagnation density, rho naught. Okay, like that. Stagnation at velocity, C naught, etc., 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 etc. Any notation, if it is shown as naught, T naught, P naught, A naught, H naught, rho naught, we are taking it as a stagnation state. That is, C naught is not. C equal to zero. C equal to zero. There is no C naught value. Velocity equal to zero, we can say it is stagnation state. Okay. So what is stagnation enthalpy? What is stagnation temperature? What is stagnation pressure? Something we want to study. That is one thing we want to study for the next topic. So Mach number m equal to c by a, stagnation state is something state where the process decelerating to zero velocity denoted by not values. So let us consider stagnation enthalpy. Let us study about stagnation enthalpy. Stagnation enthalpy. So stagnation enthalpy. So just the explanation of state of fluid obtained by process when it is isentropic to zero velocity, zero elevation. So you can use this definition itself for stagnation pressure, temperature, enthalpy, anything. You just want to change the value of it is taken as state of fluid. Okay, just for finding the definition for stagnation enthalpy, you just want to add a stagnation enthalpy. That is, stagnation enthalpy of a fluid is enthalpy of the fluid when the process is isentropically decelerating to zero velocity at zero elevation. If you want to know the definition for stagnation pressure, you just want to change the heading only. That is, stagnation pressure is a pressure obtained when a process is isentropically decelerating to zero velocity, zero elevation. And again, for stagnation velocity, velocity of sound, stagnation density, etc., etc., all definitions are same. Just you want to add, remove that topic. Difference are same for stagnation enthalpy is an enthalpy of a process. It is an enthalpy of a process where enthalpy of a process where it is decelerating to zero velocity and zero elevation. Okay, zero elevation. That is the definition for stagnation enthalpy. And you want to know an equation for stagnation enthalpy, H naught. So simply we can find the value for H naught. That is, here we have a process initially, and the process is leading to a settling chamber. Which chamber? Another thing, process initial state and final state. If when the process reaches to that particular settling chamber, the process is coming to rest. Okay. So initial conditions are C, P, T, etc. C, T, velocity C, pressure P, temperature H, enthalpy H, etc. Thereafter, when it comes to rest in setting chamber, the chamber has to take one rusty and when it comes to rest, T equal to zero, velocity equal to zero, right? Pressure equal to P naught. When it is come to rest, pressure is taken as stagnation pressure, temperature is taken as stagnation temperature, enthalpy is taken as stagnation enthalpy, H naught, T naught, etc., etc., etc. And the process is coming to rest. So we are taking a setting chamber, incoming pressure of P, T, H, and C, initial properties. And finally, when it's come to rest, we are taking it as naught values, stagnation values. So we can just use the equation, our that is H adiabatic equation. Okay, using adiabatic equation, that is H1 plus C1 square by 2 equal to H2 plus C2 square by 2, initial and final condition. So initially, H1 equal to H here, right? H1 equal to H here. And what is C1? C1 equal to C, initial velocity C, coming one. And what is final one? H2. H2 equal to H naught, right? H2 equal to H naught. What is C here?
Zero.
What is Z here?
Zero.
Zero, right. Very good, very good. C equal to zero. But I think the logic means like that. Initial conditions are taking C, P, T, and H. One and two word in the lag. Another exit, no, there is no two conditions. So it is coming to rest. So initially, just you are taking C, P, T, and H. Final condition, it is coming to rest inside a setting chamber. The chamber at the rest chamber. Okay. Then we are taking C is equal to zero, P equal to P naught, T equal to etc. Initial condition is H1 equal to H on in this equation. Final condition is H should equal to H naught on. Just substitute this value here. Just substitute the whole values here. You will get H1 equal to H. That is H plus C square by 2. H plus C square by 2. C1 is C equal to H2. H naught plus zero. H naught plus zero. You will get directly the equation for H naught. The equation will be H naught equal to H plus C square by 2. Just using the adiabatic equation to solve the problem. So you can also define the equation as, is a stagnation enthalpy is an enthalpy when the process is adiabatically decelerating zero velocity. Adiabatically and isentropically is same. That is, reversible adiabatic is isentropic. Reversible adiabatic is isentropic. So reversibly adiabatic more and isentropic more. So here you are taking adiabatic equation here and just substituting the values and arriving at equation that H naught equal to H plus C square by 2. That is, H naught equal to enthalpy plus C square by 2 means that kinetic energy. That is the equation for stagnation enthalpy. Like that, we are arriving at the equation for stagnation temperature, pressure, and density. Okay, that we can discuss in our next session. One minute.